Привет всем. Hi, I am happy to speak at PGCon 2020 Virtual Edition Conference. Today I will talk about JSONB roadmap. I am Oleg Bartunov. I work at Moscow University and Postgres professional company. I work with Postgres since Postgres 95, and here is a illustration, graphical illustration of project in Postgres, of my project in Postgres. The first one is introducing locale support to Postgres when Postgres became international database. My colleague Nikita Glukhov, he is core developer at Postgres professional company. He is Postgres contributor and principal developer of SQL JSON. Also, he contributes a lot of features to the core of Postgres. I and Theodor Sigaev, we introduced some NoSQL features in 2003, long time ago, when we developed HStore data type, which is a Perl-like hash storage without nesting, without arrays, but it was binary data type and it has indexing support. So HStore became very quickly a very popular extension, and many people enjoy NoSQL features in Postgres for many, many years. It's still a popular extension. In 2012, in Postgres, we got JSON. JSON as textual storage with some with validation support. But in 2014, I and Theodor Sigaev, we introduced JSONB, binary storage with nesting objects and array support, a lot of indexing, and it becomes very popular extension, very popular data type in Postgres. In 2019, we got JSONPass. PG12, we got JSONPass support, which is a part of SQL JSON standard. It has also indexing support. So Postgres, NoSQL Postgres actually has a long history. Here's some very brief overview of JSON in Postgres. Actually, we have two JSON data types. One is a textual JSON, another is binary JSON. Some people said better JSON. This very simple select illustrates the difference between JSONB and JSON. We see that JSON preserves white spaces, order, duplicated case, but JSONB doesn't preserve white spaces and no duplicated case, last k win. All keys are sorted by length and then key name. JSONB has binary storage. That means that we don't need to parse every time we access JSONB. It has indexes support. It has a lot of functions and arrow operators to access keys. So JSONB has a great performance thanks to indexes, and performance is comparable to the very popular NoSQL databases. Also, there is a JS query extension, which provides JSON query language with gene index support. Postgres becomes very popular since introducing JSONB. We see on this plot that popularity of Postgres rises since introducing JSONB. Other databases remains some or a bit degrades, but Postgres is growing and growing. Success of Postgres, success of JSON in Postgres, somehow influenced SQL committee, and SQL Foundation recognized JSON. And in the fall of 2016, we got specification of JSON support in SQL. So it describes, it introduced data model, JSON path language. This path language describes a projection, a part of JSON data to be used by SQL JSON functions. SQL JSON functions, they have They consist of construction functions. So values of SQL types converts to JSON values, and query functions, where JSON values converts to SQL types. In PostgreSQL, we choose to support JSONB as a practical subset of SQL JSON data model with ordered and unique keys. It's a practical, it's a good approximation for SQL standard. And we first started with implementation of JSON Pass language, because this is most important part of SQL JSON, and it was committed to PG12. SQL JSON function is also very important, but we already have constructor functions, which is sort of a wrapper around JSONB construction functions. We need to implement query functions, yes, and also we implemented indexes. Actually, we can use already existing indexes, built-in index access method, and JS query of classes. We need to add support of JSON pass to existing of classes to support some specific features of JSON pass. But actually, this is what we have for now. JSON pass query language is flexible query language, which specify the parts of JSON. The syntax is very familiar to the application developers. So it uses dot notation to access members. We have dollar sign, it describes the current context element. We have access to the arrays and elements of arrays. We can use filters and item methods. This is example of how JSON query, JSON pass works. In this example, we consider floor or house with two floors with apartments, and we want to find the apartment which has rooms in specified area, more than 40 and less than 90, so medium-sized room. So on the first step, we have dollar sign, which is a JSON itself. We see the on the picture the graphical representation of this house. And on the second step, we got array floor. Then we got array of two floors and apartments. It's two arrays of objects, actually apartments in each floor. On the fifth step, we extract five objects, apartments. And then each apartment filtered by filter expression. And the result is a sequence of two SQL JSON items. You can see on the green. We see that this apartment has room 80, and this apartment has room with area 60. So this is how expression works. SQL JSON standard conformance is in Postgres is very good for JSON pass. We support 15 out of 15 features of JSON pass, and Postgres 13 has the best implementation of JSON pass if we compare with Oracle, MySQL, and SQL Server. More information about JSON pass you can see it from my talk at Milan last year. Here's the link, just click. JSONB indexing has we have two op classes. One is default JSONB ops and another JSONB hash ops. So this slide shows how actually key and value, how actually JSONB index. So JSONB ops extract keys and values separately. It provides operations, top level exists operators, contains operators, but overlapping of large postings for keys and values may be quite slow. JSONB hash ops extract hashes of paths. So it supports only contains operator, but it's much faster and smaller than default op class for contains operator. And the performance is comparable to the famous NoSQL databases. So now we are going to talk about roadmap ideas. So first we will talk about generic JSON IP and discuss the possibility of grand unification of two JSON data types. Then we talk about JSONB partial decompression, SQL JSON functions, planner support functions, JSON pass as parameters for JSONB of classes, JS query gene of class to core, JSON pass syntax extension, and simple dot notation access to JSON data. This is just not just ideas. Most of these items, or most of these topics, we already have prototypes, working prototypes, and I will, in the last slide, you will see the links to the GitHub repositories where you can try, you can play and give us feedback or your thinking. We are open for discussion. So let's start from generic JSON API. I would say JSON and the grand unification. Why JSON? We have two JSON implementation of two data types and two implementation of user functions. You see the screenshot, you can see the a lot of JSON functions and much more JSONB functions. And we see the some overlap of these functions. So it's, we have a lot of, maybe a lot of duplicated functionality, some code, and if we introduced support of JSON and SQL JSON, so we will need a lot of work, duplicated work. So we don't want, we need some unified interface. Also, the coming SQL standard will specify JSON data type. For example, Oracle 20C in preview already introduced JSON data type, and they introduce also binary format or SON. And for the sake of compatibility with the SQL standard, we need just one JSON data type. And we wish that it will internally be JSONB by default, and somehow we could specify to behave as all textual JSON. So for example, the syntax maybe looks like JSON with some modifiers. So here comes the idea of generic JSON API. Generic JSON API or JSON. So the current JSON API is looks like this. We have two separate API for JSON and JSONB. JSON has lexer and parser with visitor interface, and JSONB use JSON lexer and parser for input and several functions and iterators for access. This makes very difficult to implement JSON pass functions. So we support only JSONB in JSON pass. Not easy to add some new features to JSON like partial decompression, detoasting, different storage format. So that's why we come to the new API, JSON, which based on JSON API, and it allows easy to implement new features and add JSON support to JSON path and SQL JSON. So using JSON, we removed old code for JSON functions and operators. JSON and JSONB user functions have only a separate entry in which input datum wrapped to the JSON structure, but the body of the functions are the same. They just called generic subroutines. So SQL JSON use this generic subroutines and generic JSON pass API. Using JSON, it's easy to add some new features. For example, partial access to the compressed data or partial dictionary decompression. So if JSON be stored with compressed, so keys all we have separate dictionary for keys. So for example, to implement some new feature, we need just to implement container ops interface. Actually, it has two mandatory methods, init and iterator init. Other methods could be used from default implementation. Using JSON is just a step forward to unified JSON data type, because it unifies implementation of user function. But actually, it doesn't solve the problem of unified JSON data type as required by SQL standard. So we have three options. Do nothing. JSON as from standard, but application will be slow because JSON is a plain text. Second option is introduce SQL JSON compatibility mode, where JSON becomes is an alias of JSONB. And the third option is right option is to implement pluggable storage method for data type, which doesn't exist in POSIX. In case of JSON, it means that only one JSON data type exists and several storage formats like text, binary, compressed binary, and one set of functions. So we see the direction of development from 1 to 3. So at first stage, we do nothing. So JSON application will be happy but slow. Then we need to discuss how to make it right, a compatibility mode. So JSON becomes alias of JSONB, and there will be no JSON. And then in parallel, implement pluggable storage. And that we will be happy. I don't know how many releases it will require, but it looks like a good plan. So example of using JSON is a JSONB partial decompression. Let me explain what it is. Current JSONB works with fully decompressed binary JSONB data. So it cannot benefit from partial PGLZ decompression. With JSON API, it's easy to implement partial decompression with resume support for JSONB. And we modified PGLZ code to provide ability to caller to preserve the compression state between successive calls, so we can resume decompression. And prototype currently supports only partial PGLZ decompression, but in principle, it is possible to use partial detoasting and even future detoasting with slicing. Here is the example. We generate a key table with 100,000 JSONB of size 128 kilobytes, which compressed to 1.2 kilobytes, so no toast. And another table is long keys. So JSONB will be toasted. And here we measure the performance of access to the different keys. And on the left picture, we see the no toast and right with toast. We see huge difference in performance. For to access key one, the first key and the last key. And we see that partial decompression can greatly improve access to the keys in both cases. In TOS case, effect maybe is lesser than no TOS case, but still big. So this is just free benefit from using partial decompression, which based on generic JSON API. If we compare JSON paths and arrow operators, we see that for multi-level for nesting JSONB, we see that JSON path is much faster than arrow operators, because this is a violet. This is a JSON path, partial key K1, and in green, and the upper one is a partial arrow operators. Because in the JSON path, we can do decompression inside function, but between calling operators, it is impossible. So we have slow access. So this example illustrates the one of the benefit of using JSON path. So a summary of JSONB partial decompression is that accessing data in the beginning of compressed JSONB is much faster without any modification of user function. JSON support can be added later. Multi-level JSON paths is much faster than chained arrow operators for compared JSONB, since JSON path functions benefit from PGLZ resume between levels. It's possible to add partial detoasting, prefix, and slice. So now we have lifehack. Lifehack is that keep important keys in the beginning, and access to the keys will be much, to these keys will be much faster. SQL JSON function. SQL JSON function constructs functions. Actually, this is a wrapper around existed JSONB functions. You see that we have JSONB object, which constructs JSON object. We have JSONB build object functions, JSON array, JSON array aggregate, JSON object aggregate. Also, we have JSON retrieval function, JSON value, which extract SQL value of predefined type from JSON value. A JSON query, it's extract JSON text from JSON text using SQL JSON path expression. JSON table, query JSON text and present its relational table. Is not JSON, the test and JSON exist. And the most important is JSON table. It's a relational view of JSON. So here's an example how to get rooms from JSON in relational form as a table. So you can use result of this select in other selects, for example, to join with other tables. So so SQL JSON actually is very nice to have, but mostly we're interested in JSON table. Another topic is parameter for op classes. Parameter of for op classes is operator classes is a collection of access method, set of operators, and some access method specific support function. For example, you see the names in bold. This is an op classes. When you create index for B3, for example, you can specify a specific op class. for JSONB or for, you can use JSONB ops. This is a default op class. You can omit it. But if you want to use a JSONB path ops, you should specify it here. We need to extend index infrastructure because op classes, they have hard-coded constant. For example, gist op class for TS vector or for arrays, they use hard-coded size of signature or binary signature. Op classes allows you to define these constants outside of op classes. For example, signature size for different data may be different. And this was committed to PG13. Also, we can use different algorithms to index. It depends on the data. For indexing of non-atomic data, Postgres has non-atomic data type like arrays, JSON, JSONB, TS vector, and other. We can specify what part of column value to index. It's not like partial index. It's sort of functional index. But we don't need to use exact expression in SQL as for functional index. Because op class already knows what to index. But with functional index, op class doesn't know. It just index what comes. More details about op classes, about parameters for op class, you can see from our talk at PGCon 2 years ago. Here is a syntax for parameters for op classes and examples how to specify signature. For example, for int array, we can specify signature 32 bytes and default num range is 100. For indexing JSONB, we can specify which part of JSON tree to index. In this example, we see parameters called projection and some JSON path. Op classes parameters can be used in JSONB op classes for selective indexing of parts of JSONB document. We implemented a projection parameter for in-core op classes for JSONB. Examples, here is examples. If we use JSON path extension, we'll talk about later for sequence construction. We can index multiple paths, multiple branches of JSONB tree. Here is an example. We have a projection parameter, which describes two branches of JSONB tree. So ID and rows. This example uses IMDb names table. Let's compare full functional and a selective JSONB indexes on IMDb titles. Full index syntax is very simple. Functional index, we have to create a function special title, ID, kind, year. We want to specify that we want to index ID, kind, and year. Branches from the IMDb tables and create index using these functions. The last example is selective index, which use parameters for a class. We specify projection. As you see, we don't need to specify any functions. The syntax is very clear. And JSONB path ops op class knows about these parameters, knows what to index. Resulted index and build time is as expected. Full index is much bigger and takes a lot of time, much more time. Functional index and selective index have the same, more or less, the same size and the same building time, build time. Let's see the examples. Let's first the performance of queries. Let's see the consider a simple query which contains only index paths. So we want to find the titles of movies, of episode kind, episode and released in 2016. So the first full and selective indexes, they have the same syntax. And here is an example of execution plan for selective index. We see the time is 386 milliseconds. It used index index and do some recheck. For functional index, query should include index condition. So we should use specific, we should use the query the same as we use for the creating index. And execution time is almost two times more. It's about 600 milliseconds because recheck is more difficult, functional recheck. Situation becomes more interesting when we have a more complex query where we have indexed conditions and non-indexable conditions. For example, let's add some title to the query. And we know that index doesn't know about title. So for in case of selective index, nothing change in the query. We just add title and we have index scan and recheck because index doesn't know about title. So this recheck just filtered by title. And we have 382 milliseconds. But if we write the same query, previous query for functional index, also add title, this will not work. We'll have a zero result because this is a wrong query. We should use very different query, simple query, and add and different operator for title, for filtering title. And then this query will works and execution time again, slower than for selective indexes. Selective JSON B op class support various users operators, additional non-index conditions logically ended, not or, but ended. As we seen on the previous slides, it supports array, subscripts, some strict locks, index query path combinations. It doesn't support yet filters, expressions, and item methods. So the main conclusion for parameter for JSON B selective index is that query much simple. You don't need to invent special syntax as in case for functional index. And it's not only faster, but also more performant. JS query extensions has some indexes which we would like to, which we want to move to the core. One JSON B path value ops, it's support exact and range queries on values and exact path searches. So as you know, the in core op classes, JSON B op classes doesn't support this. So JSONB value path ops. It's support value search exact and wildcard path queries. New one, which we implemented recently to support JSON path. It's the same as JSON path value ops, but ignored array path items. And this greatly simplifies extraction of JSON path queries. Also, jQuery provides debugging and query optimizer with hints, but this will not move to core. Here is an example how JSON path value ops is slow for long logs path. Simple table with empty JSONB. We have 1 million empty JSONB, and we create index using JSONB path value ops and try to find all rows which satisfy this condition with this JSON path. Very simple. We have planning time, half of milliseconds and 3 milliseconds execution time. This is quite slow because for this JSON path, op class should extract 124 entries. We have gndebug JSON path value functions in jQuery, which shows you all entries. Obviously, the query should be slow. If we add support of JSON path, which is JSONB logs path value ops, it doesn't account arrays in path, and the same query runs much faster. So planning time is 10 times faster, and execution time is 120 times faster. Because for this JSON path op class, JSONB lacks path value ops, extracts only one entry as expected, not 1024. So this is very nice addition to the existing op classes. Planner support functions for the planner support for JSON path. Recently in PG12, API for planner support function appeared. It allows transform functions to operators expressions. And this operator expression can be accelerated by indexes. So we implemented this support for JSONB, and JSONB pass match function, for example, transforms to this operator. And this operator, for this operator, we have index. And what also important that it pass variables to operators, which is impossible, but JSONB pass match, they accept variables. Here's the example. We have this query, and we see the execution plan. We have index for this column in table T1. Actually, this is a self-join. And we see that function JSONB path match converted to the operator. And to this operator, parameters pass. So for each row, we have sequential scan on second table. And this value transforms to the pseudo constant, which can be used for in the operator. So this operator, JSON path embed vars, these functions, they produce a constant. And we will have in the index conditions, indexable expression, index operators. So it's very useful, and we won't plan to support it, to commit it to Postgres. JSON path syntax extension. SQL query standard describes syntax for JSON path, but we miss some very obvious functionality, some very convenient functionality. So we want to add to the Postgres. For example, array construction index. So we, from array 1 to 3, we want to add two members from left and from right, from the beginning and to the end. With this syntax, it's very easy. It looks very, very natural. The same with object construction index. Sequence construction index. Very natural, and I think that is very useful. I remind that sequence construction index is useful for specifying several paths to the op class. Here is an example of this sequence. Object and array construction syntax useful for constructing some derived objects. For example, if we consider this query from INDB database, we got execution time around 13.5 seconds. If we don't use this constructor and use some standard syntaxes of which specified by SQL standard, we can write this query, but it is also slow. It's longer, more complex, and it's also slow. If we don't use SQL JSON functions and use arrow operators, we get even more difficult query and even 2 times slower query. So syntax extensions not only more convenient way, but also sometimes more faster way. We can use array and sequence construction syntax for simplification of inquiries, for example. Another syntax extension is object subscripting. So we can say that looks also natural. Object subscripting, easy to use it. Array items with lambda expressions. If you know what is a lambda, you understand that it is very powerful way to work with JSON. So we have map, reduce, fold, max function support already. We can use sequence functions with lambda expressions. Again, map, reduce, fold, max. And I think that this extension would be very useful for developers. Simple dot notation access to JSON data. Sometimes it's much easier for simple queries. Dot notation can be much better than arrow operators and functions. For example, we can write j.k1.k2 instead of these two arrow operators, or instead of JSON query functions. Access to array could be more easy, more familiar than using arrow operator and JSON query. This is idea. We did not try to implement it. I know that Oracle already implemented dot notation. So it's just an idea. So what's the status of this roadmap? Generic JSON API would be nice to implement for PG 14. Here's a link to the repository at GitHub. The grant unification is not clear, need help. We need to discuss to elaborate our proposal what to do. JSON B partial decompression also would be nice to have in PG14. Also, we have a prototype at GitHub. SQL JSON function from SQL standard certainly should go to PG14. We have a repository. We have patches published in hackers mailing list. We have long discussions. So invite you to join this discussion. PG14 planner support functions also would be nice to have in PG14. We have also prototype at GitHub. JSON pass as parameter for JSON B of classes. We want to commit to PG14. We have also GitHub repository. GSQuery from Gin classes from GSQuery should be easy to commit to PG14. Here is a link to the GitHub. JSON pass syntax extension also we have repository and also would like to commit to PG14. Simple dot notation access is just idea. Another idea is copy with support of JSON pass. We don't have any prototype, but it would be very, very nice because if you download JSON data from internet, they usually consist of array of JSONs. And it is not, there is no easy way to, for example, to load to Postgres. Where if we specify copy with JSON pass, you can easy load to Postgres specific parts of JSON data, not all, but some specific parts. So I think that idea is worth to think and try. We need developers. So as you see, the roadmap and all this project roadmap is more or less okay, good. We work on it for several years. There is a lot of work was done, a lot of work needed. So contact me and Nikita for collaboration. This is a open, this is a Postgres community project, and we need more developers to implement all this. Together we can do anything. So references. You can download slides from the links above, then read about standard from technical report, my introduction to JSON pass, JSQuery extensions, a link to parameters for our classes, and you can download INDB tables to play with JSONs. And here is how JSON in Postgres logo transformed. First, we have an elephant with a trunk in the form of JSON logotip. Then I got idea to have brackets around elephant to say that this is some JSON. Because people don't know how JSON logo looks like. And then Denis Rosa, I posted it in Twitter, and Denis Rosa provide the feedback in the form of my elephant with the ears in the form of bracket. Thank you, Denis Rosa, for this. And this is the last slide of my presentation. I like it because contemplation sometimes is just a start for the big things. Again, thank you for attention. I hope that we will work together on improving NoSQL Postgres. And I want to say that you see this guy, which is starring, and this is how I look after finishing slides these nights. The mountain in the background is the Makalu, the fifth highest mountain. This picture I made in 2014 when we introduced JSONB, and then we went to the big adventure in Nepal mountain. This is the Barunzi Plateau. Altitude is more than 6,000 meters. Enjoy this picture. Thank you for attending.